Okay. So we've got our bands today for some more resistance work and just to mix up some of the exercises we've been doing so far. So there'll be a few familiar ones and then a couple of new ones. And we'll use the band for pretty much everything today. We'll just start lying on our backs. So lay on down and have your band in your hands, about shoulder width apart, or maybe even just slightly wider than your shoulders, and just rest your feet flat on the floor. I'm going to get you to open the band a little bit wider than shoulder width, so you'll just feel a little bit of tension outwards on the band, and then we'll just raise the hands back and overhead, and then up to the ceiling again. So I want you to breathe out as your hands go overhead, and then breathe in as your hands come back to the ceiling. As your arms are reaching overhead, try and keep your rib cage sinking down so that you've got a little bit of heaviness through the front of the ribs there and a little bit of activity through your stomach muscles. Whilst you're doing this, also try and engage your pelvic floor. So we'll spend a little bit of time on pelvic floor as we work through these arms. So when you switch on through your pelvic floor, it should feel really internal. There shouldn't be any squeezing of your buttock cheeks or your thigh muscles or anything else. It just should feel like a little lifting sensation, as if you're doing the least amount of effort you would have to hold on for the loo. You breathe out as you go overhead and then as you come back. And I want you to see if you can hold that pelvic floor contraction for the next three overhead arms. Good. Keeping a little bit of space under your lower back. Two. And then one more time, overhead and back to the ceiling. Let's keep that little bit of tension on the band. We're going to breathe out, bringing the right leg to tabletop position, and then breathe in to put it down. Good, and the left, breathe out to lift, in to lower. So as you're alternating here, again, feeling that gentle contraction through your pelvic floor. Try and feel through the back of your pelvis that you're not shifting your weight from side to side. So you should feel like all your weight is just resting on that tailbone area at the back of your pelvis as you lift one at a time. Through the front of your stomach, you should feel that just gentle tension between the pelvis bones, like you're drawing your belly down towards your spine a little bit. Good. Keep up the breathing. So it's a breath out to lift and then a breath in to lower. One more time on the left. And then we'll have a go at lifting up into double tabletop. So let's lift the right leg, lift the left. Good, lower the right and lower the left. We've still got that tension on the band with our arms, just working a little bit through the backs and sides of the shoulders to keep it where it is. Keep going with this up, up, down, down pattern. And through your neck and shoulders, I want you to feel as though your collarbones are broad and your shoulder blades are resting back on the floor. So you shouldn't be lifting your shoulders up away from the ground. They should just be resting nice and flat. And through your neck, you want a bit of length at the back of the neck. So you'll almost feel like you're drawing your chin downwards rather than poking it upwards. Let's hold in tabletop now and stay nice and still here. We're gonna lower the hands back overhead, exhaling overhead, and then inhaling back to the ceiling. Good, exhale overhead, and then inhale to the ceiling. Keep it going, drawing belly to spine. Make sure you can feel that there's a little bit of space under your lower back, just enough for that blueberry to fit without squashing it. Trying not to flatten the back, but also trying not to let it arch. Let's go for five more, overhead and back, remembering that those ribs stay flat. So as the hands go overhead, you're not feeling the ribs flare. Three, good, two more here before we add a leg extension. Two, and one more. Good, back to the ceiling. And now as the arms go overhead, we'll stretch the right leg out. Good, and then bring that leg back in as the hands lift up, other side. Good, keep alternating. I want you to feel now as the leg lengthens that you're working a little bit harder through your lower abdominals to keep that spine neutral. So as your leg stretches away from you, your lower back will want to arch and you need to work through your tummy to stop it from doing so. Exhale as you lengthen away Inhale as you come back. Good. Let's go for another four on each side. Just working at your own breathing pace. Three. Two more here before we have a little break from these arms. Good. And then one more for each side. Last one on the left. Good. And then rest the feet down. Well done. We're going to place the band now behind our backs. All right. So in underneath your shoulder blades, and it will just sort of sit out under your armpits there. We're going to come into a chest press with the arms. So the arm movement, you'll hold your elbows nice and narrow by your sides to start with, is to press straight up to the ceiling and then back down. Okay, so we stretch up and down. We're going to do this in a bridge position though. So press through your heels, flatten your lower back, pull your pubic bone towards your belly button, really squeeze your buttock muscles and press your hips to the ceiling. Once you're in your bridge, make sure you're connecting between the ribs and the hips. And let's exhale, press the hands to the ceiling. Inhale, bend by your sides. Exhale, press. Inhale, bend. Well done. Keep this going. We've got our elbows narrow to start with. So in your bridge shape, we want to be using the backs of the legs, the buttock muscles, and the stomach muscles. So make sure those ribs and hips are drawing towards each other. Try not to arch your back. All right, so if you feel like you're trying to flare your rib cage here to get extra height, just sink the ribs down. It's not really about how high you can go. It's about which muscles you're using. Let's do five more of these arms before we take the elbows out wide. Keep lifting those hips up. If they've dropped a bit, maybe push them a little bit higher and tuck the pelvis under a little bit more firmly. Two and one, hold at the ceiling. Turn your fists around to face your thighs and then bend your elbows out wide and back to the ceiling. We're here for 10. Good. Just have a quick look at your body. Make sure those ribs and hips are sinking towards each other. Pulling through your tummy muscles at the front and pushing through your buttock muscles at the back. Let's go for another five. Good. Still holding our bridge. Four. Three. Pushing the hips to the ceiling. Two. One more, press and hold. Keep your hands pointing at the ceiling. Body stays nice and stable. Squeeze your left buttock nice and firmly and lift your right foot off the floor. Well done. Pop that foot down. Squeeze your right buttock nice and firmly and lift your left foot off the floor. We're alternating here, bringing the leg to tabletop. Ideally, when your leg lifts, your hips don't move, and that can be really hard. So you've really got to get that co-contraction between the stomach muscles and the buttock muscles working. If you really ground your heel into the ground, press down through the heel, squeeze the buttock muscle, use the back of the leg as you lift, and let's keep alternating here. Go for another six. Pushing those hands to the ceiling. Five. Tucking your bottom in. Four. Three. And two. And one more, foot comes down and we'll roll the spine all the way down. Well done. Let's pop our band down for a moment. We're gonna give our hands a little bit of a break from gripping onto that band. We will just keep it within reach. So bring your legs back to tabletop, one at a time. Hold them there. Reach your hands back to the ceiling. We're going to be doing a similar movement to before. Arms go overhead. One leg stretches out, but this time we'll add our chest lift. So bring the hands up to the ceiling, pull the leg in, curl forwards, pause at the top, and then we lie down. The opposite leg extends, the hands go overhead. We bring the leg in, we reach the arms long, and we curl forward. Good. So stretch out on the exhale. Inhale, come back in to that crunch. Exhale, lengthen. Inhale, lift up. Good. Keep it going. As you lengthen long, make sure you're staying connected through the front of your body. And as you curl forwards, try and initiate the movement at your rib cage. So the ribs are staying flat as we lengthen out, and then they're sinking even deeper as we curl up. And you really want to get the sensation that your head, neck, and shoulders are just following along as the rib cage curls forward. So it's like your neck and shoulders are just one with the rest of your body. the abdominals are doing the work. There's no strain in the neck. If you're starting to feel a bit of a strain, place your hands behind your head and just support the weight of your head for your neck. Otherwise, we'll keep going. We've got a few more here before we progress to our double leg extensions. And if you want to just stay with your head down, you can. And if you'd like to just stick to your single leg extensions, you can. And if you'd like to just keep your legs at tabletop and work through the upper body only, that's fine as well. Let's go for another three. And lift. Two. And lift. One more. Well done. Curl up and pause. And now if you're with me, let's go both legs together. Squeeze the knees together. Use the inner thighs. Stretch them out. Arms go overhead. And then reach either side of the thighs. Curl forwards. Stretch out. Arms reach. And then we curl up and over. Now as those legs go long, again, make sure your lower back doesn't let arch. So you might want to reach your feet a little bit higher if you're finding that your lower back is arching as you go low. Up to you. Pick your challenge. The most important thing is that you can do the movement properly. Nothing to do with how far or how low you go. It's all about the quality. Let's do three more here. And we'll hold it at the top for some pulses. Two. Good. One more. Let's curl up and hold. Turn the palms to face down and pulse those hands up and down. Make sure you're still breathing, pulsing as you breathe. Little pulses, down, down, down. You can kind of imagine, it's a bit strange, but imagine like you're kind of patting your hands on top of water. So it's just this light little bobbing sensation. Let's do five more of these and then we're placing our hands behind our heads. Now, hold there. I know you girls loved the crisscross, so that's what we're going to next. Stretch your right leg out. Turn your chest towards that left thigh. Good. Get that rotation through the rib cage back to the center. And then swap. Left leg extends. And we turn to the right. Good. So we go across, middle. Across, middle. Keep alternating. Five. Good. Four, make sure you meet in the middle. That's important. Three, two, one more. We're facing the right. The left leg is long. We do our five little crunches towards that right knee. Four, three. Good. Left rib crossing towards the right hip. One, come back to the middle. And we crisscross again. Good. Make sure that you can feel your body weight resting on your tailbone. We don't want to be sloppy with this. Take it as slow as you need to do it properly. So if you're feeling like your pelvis is kind of shifting all over the place, just slow it down a little bit and maybe don't twist as far. Good. Last one. Turn to the left. Let's hold here. We've got our five oblique crunches. Five, four, three, two, and one, and rest. Well done. Rock the knees side to side. Have a little massage of the spine. Good. All right. So grab onto your band. Push one foot to the floor. Hook your band around the back of the other foot. Stretch your leg to the ceiling. We're just going to do a quick little stretch of the hamstrings before we get into our leg work. So pulling down on the toes, pulling the foot towards you, and then we're just going to bend and straighten through that knee. Bend. And straighten. As the leg straightens, I want you to feel that stretch. Let's do another five. Good. Four. Three. Two. And one. Press your leg to the ceiling and hold. Good. If you want to wave that leg side to side a bit, you'll feel the stretch change. It's nice having the support of the band. I like doing these stretches. And then let's pull that leg down. And then I want you to roll onto your side. And we're going to hook the band around that same foot. So I've got my right foot band hooked around it. Left hand, sorry, you're on your left elbow or on the opposite elbow and you're holding onto the band with that arm. And then you're putting your opposite hand on your hip. Once you're set up there, and it can take a moment to get into position, stretch that top leg out nice and long. So the same leg that you just stretched. Push through your elbow so that you're nice and switched on under that armpit rather than sort of sagging through the shoulder. Lift up, hand on hip, and we're going to do some knee bends. Now, when your knee bends, it should go above your strap. Bend and straighten. Good. Keep your foot nice and flat and lead with your heel and really squeeze the leg straight. So when you push it out, squeeze it straight, squeeze your butt, squeeze your thigh, and make sure it's stretching into the band. Let's bend and straighten. Good. Whilst you hold the band with your opposite arm. Let's do five more of these. Good. Keep that tension on the band. So try not to move the arm that's holding the band. And again, press through the heel and straighten the leg. Just have a quick look at your leg. Make sure that when it's straight, it's back in line with your hips, so you're not finishing in front of your midline. Three more here. Good. Two more. And that bottom leg should be nice and relaxed. One more. Press out. Hold there. Turn your toes towards the ceiling. Bend your knee up really high now. We've got our frog press. So still going above the band, but quite a bit further above the band this time. Have a little check that you haven't rolled that hip backwards. So you want to really stay square through your pelvis and work through the hip to rotate the knee outwards. So all that effort coming from the buttock of the leg that you're pressing. Three more here. And then we'll hold the leg long. Two. One more. Stretch out and hold. Let's turn our foot forward again. We'll wave the leg forwards and back. Forwards and back. We're going to do something a little bit fancy with our ankles now. So as your foot comes forward, your toes are lifted. And as your foot goes back, I want you to point the toes. So flat foot forwards, toes point to come back. Flat foot comes forward, that's it. Toes point to come back. Now, if you don't have a band or not with your band, I would just do this without the band. Still gets a good workout, even just against gravity. Let's go five. Left shoulder's feeling it two. Make sure that shoulder blade's pulling back and you're lifting up. Three, two. One more, stretch it long, hold it still, reach a little further and let's circle 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. We're going back the other way after this. One, back the other way, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring it in. Give it a little rub. Now we're going to keep the band around that same foot. You might just need to fan it out like that. Come over onto your hands and knees, holding the band under the same hand. So your hands can go flat on the ground. Your knee is on the ground as well. We're in our four-point kneeling position. There should be a little bit of tension on that band to start with. Press down through your palms, flatten through your shoulder blades, and draw your belly button up towards your spine. When you're ready, we'll press firmly through that right hand and the left knee and we'll stretch the right leg back behind us. Bend it to come back in. Good. And then stretch it out. Good. And bend. When your leg stretches out, try and get it to come up to about the same level as your hip. So try not to stop too low. Having said that, only lift your leg as high as you can without feeling your lower back arch. So you want to stay nice and solid through your lower back as that leg lifts and lowers. Let's just do three more here. Three, good. Trying not to shift too much weight over to that left side. Two, one more, stretch your leg long, hold it long. Let's pulse up to the ceiling. Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Bring your knee down, but leave the band on the foot and just sit back into your child's pose. So we're going to progress that into a full plank version. So come forwards onto your hands again. Make sure your band's hooked around your foot nicely. And then we're going to step the right leg back. Okay. Whoops. Hook that around. And come into your plank. All right. Whoops. Hopefully you guys are having more luck than me. Right, From there, we'll kick back. Okay, tuck in and kick back for another 8. Good. 7, pressing through the palms. 6. 5 more here. 4. 3. Good. Last 2. Really squeezing that right leg out straight behind you. 1 more. Stretch it long. 5 little pulses. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Well done. A few little bloopers there. Let's lie down on our backs again. And this time we'll hook the band around the back of the left foot. So lay on down, right leg on the ground, left foot stretched up to the ceiling, feeling that nice stretch down the back of your leg. While you're here, push the other leg flat against the floor so that you're opening through the front of that hip. Let's hold here if you want to start bending and straightening that leg. Or you can start waving it side to side. Whatever feels good to you. I like the waving. Try and keep your pelvis square, even as you wave your leg across. So the movement is all coming from the hip. Come back to the middle. Really stretch that leg up in front of you. Good. And then let's let that go. We've got the band around the arch of the left foot now. And we're coming onto the right side. So we'll place the band into the right hand. Push up through that right shoulder. Press the left leg out nice and long. Hand on your hip. When you're ready, let's start bending and straightening. Good. So when you bend, your knee goes above the strap, but it is still about the same height as your hip. So we're working at a flat level here. Push up through that right elbow. Lift your chest away from the floor. And try and sort of guide the shoulder blade back, flush against your rib cage, rather than letting the shoulder tip forward. Good, pressing through your heel to really squeeze that leg out straight. Got 3 more like this before we move into our frog shape. 2. 1 more, press long, turn the toes towards the ceiling. Don't let this hip rotate backwards as you bend up towards the ceiling and then back out long. Bend up and then press out. Good, 8 more of these. Good, really leading from the heel. Push up through that bottom arm. 6 more before we go into our straight leg. 5, 4, good. Working to rotate that thigh outwards. 2, and 1 more. Stretch it long. Turn your feet forwards again. When you're ready, wave your foot forwards and then sweep it back. Good, forwards and back. We're gonna add that flat foot on the way forward and toes point on the way back. Flat foot forwards, point on the way back, aiming to keep your leg at that nice horizontal level in line with your hip the whole time. Got to keep correcting my shoulder blade. Forwards, good, and back. 5 more of these before we circle. And back, oops. 3, 2, and 1 more, press back. Hold long, stretch it out, 10 little circles each way. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, back the other way. 10, good, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, well done, bring that down, that bends. All right, we're going into our 4-point kneeling position now. So the band is flat under the left palm. Knees are under the hips. Press down firmly through your left hand and your right knee. Make sure you're in your neutral spine position. And when you're ready, we'll kick that left leg back. Squeeze it straight and then bend it in underneath you. Trying not to tip over to the right hand side this time. So you should feel your stomach muscles are working here. It's not all about the leg. We want to make sure the core is engaged to keep you strong. You're also working through your shoulder blades here. Keep the chest lifted away from the floor so we're not sagging down. And the back of the neck is long so that you're in a neutral position of your neck. Let's go 5. Good, lifting the leg up as high as you can without arching into your back. You should get a good squeeze of your left glute as you do that. two. One more stretch out, hold long, little pulses. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, come down. Quick child's pose. I'll try not to slingshot this time. Let's come back into your 4-point kneeling position. Step back, find a plank, and then let's lift that left leg, bend it in, stretch it out. Good. In and out. Really squeeze through your left heel, straighten the leg out. Let's do another 5 before we do our 5 pulses. Good. 3, 2, one more, stretch it out, hold it long, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Well done. Let's child's pose there. Let your head rest on the floor. Let your arms rest by your sides. 3 deep breaths here. 2, and 1 more. Well done. Felt that. All right, let's have our band. Now we're going to come into a long sitting position. I will face you so that you can see exactly what I'm doing with my arms. But hook the band around the arches of your feet or the soles of your feet and then sit tall. You're welcome to bend your knees if the backs of your legs feel a bit tight, whatever's comfortable for you. And I would suggest sort of wrapping your hands around your band so that you've got a really good grip there. So we're going to start with a narrow row. You'll be bending your elbows, pulling the arms back, squeezing the shoulder blades, and then release forward. So in sitting, just keep going. I'm going to talk you through your postural alignment here. You want to imagine that your head is a helium balloon and it's floating to the ceiling. So your neck should feel long, but your head should feel light. So there's a lengthening through the back of the neck and an elongation through the spine. When you try and sit taller, it can be really tempting to just pop the chest out and flare the ribs, but that can lead to a lot of pain around the back and a lot of overactivity of the muscles that run either side of the spine that we really don't need. So I want you to lengthen, but as you lengthen, remember the ribs to hips cue. You can imagine there's a couple of springs hooked onto your lowest ribs and then the tops of your pelvis that are just tensioning through the front of your stomach wall. So we're tall, but we're not arching and we're still engaged through the front. As you pull your elbows back, feel that the effort comes from between the shoulder blades. So if we pull the elbows, but we don't pull the shoulders, we end up popping forward through the chest and that doesn't help us. So we want to open the chest, squeeze the shoulder blades back and let that be the focus of the movement. Let's do 2 more of these narrow rows before we go into a wider row, focusing on that squeeze. 1 more, and then I'll get you to reach your arms forward, turn your fist to face downwards. Now we pull towards the armpits and we squeeze the shoulder blades still and the elbows come a little bit wider. Good. Again, just be honest with yourself. Try and make sure you're not just popping the chest out every time you pull those elbows back. Squeezing between the shoulder blades. You should feel a slightly higher squeeze now. And that's good. So you want to strengthen those muscles that sit around the tops of the shoulder blades as well as the ones that sit around the bottom. We need good strength in our upper traps muscles to support our heads, particularly if we spend a lot of time at a desk, but just anyone that's upright, which is everyone. Let's do 5 more of our wide rows. Good, getting that squeeze. 4, beautiful. 3, good. 2, 1 more. Squeeze back. Let's hold that squeeze. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and release. Good. Undo 1 of your wraps so you're not quite as tight through the arms. Tuck your elbows back by your side and just sit forward a little bit more on those sit bones. We're going to push our arms back, straighten them, and then bend them. And this is for our triceps. Push back, straighten, and bend. You'll notice I'm going just a little bit wide. If I go straight down, I touch the floor. So a little bit wide, but the effort here is on straightening the elbows so that we work the triceps, the wings. Let's do another 8. can definitely feel that. Seven, good. Six, still open through the chest. Five, four, and then we're gonna do some longer holds. Three, two, one more. Straighten the elbows, hold. Five, four, three, two, one, bend. We're gonna do that again. Straighten out and hold. Five, four, three, two, one. And again, one more time. Straighten it out, hold them straight. Little pulses with straight elbows. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, and rest. Roll your shoulders. Cross your loops over. Hold from the ends, and again, have a little wrap. Elbows are by your sides. We're doing a rotation exercise now. So you're gonna open the hands to the sides, pause there, and slowly come back in. So with these rotations, make sure that the elbows stay underneath your shoulders. So we're not opening the arms outwards. It's like two little doors hinging open, and then they close back across. Exhale to open, inhale to close, good. And we want it to be slow and controlled. Try and keep those collarbones broad, neck long, remember the balloon for your head, and the ribs drawing in. Let's go for eight, good. Lots of little muscle groups here, so they really feel when you're working them in such an isolated way. Good. Five, that's it. Four more before we again do some holding. Three, and two, that's it. One more, open hold. Let's hold for five, four, three, two, one. Let it go, well done. Roll your shoulders. I'm going to turn back to the side, but you can stay facing where you are. So we are coming into a row with some rotation now. I'm gonna have my knees a little bit bent, feet resting on the floor. And then you want to just pull probably a little bit tighter again for these. Sitting up tall, one arm's going to stay where it is, the other one will pull back and we'll twist. Okay, and then come back to the middle and you can just kind of rest the other arm on your side of your knee and then pull back and to the center. So we'll rotate as we row. Good. Feel through your sit bones that your weight is staying even on both sides. So through the bony parts of your pelvis, you can feel that the twist here is not coming from your hips or your legs. Your knees should also stay level with each other. And you should feel that your feet are staying together. If we were twisting through the pelvis as well, you'd notice that your knees shifted. So we want to try and isolate this twist to our ribs. Very nice. One more. And come back to the middle. Release a twist. And then we're coming into a bit of a roll down. So, tucking the pelvis under, roll back. Let's go about halfway and then roll forward. And you'll notice with the band that it helps you. So you, normally when we do our roll downs, you've got no assistance at all. And then roll back up. But with the band, it's just giving you a little bit. I might bend my knees. I just find it easier on my hips if my knees are bent. Roll back and then roll forwards. Good. So as we roll backwards, we roll off the sit bones onto the tailbone. We scoop the belly. Pull the pubic bone towards the belly button and feel that the effort there is through the front of the stomach wall. And then we roll back up. We're going to do a couple more of these before we add those rows with rotation to the movement. Go back and then use the tummy. Pull back up. Sit tall. Rounding through the lower back. Go as round as you can. Really draw the belly towards the spine. Good. Two more like this. Rolling and rounding, but the shoulders stay broad. Okay, let's go one more time. Roll back and hold. Hold there. Let's go left. We'll row five times to the left. Good. Again, get that twist to come from your ribs, not your hips. Three. Very nice. Right arm is just staying still. One more, and then we'll go five to the right. Let's come to the middle and row to the right. Five. Good. So as you rotate, you should feel your left rib come across towards your right hip. Three, two, and one more, and then we'll sit up. Good. Okay, let's sit all the way up. Hold there, we're going to do a set where we alternate. So we'll roll down, hold that roll. Let's go left, and middle, right and middle. Good, keep alternating. Left, right, good. Left and right. We've got two more to each side. One more to each side. Good. And roll all the way up. Well done. Sitting tall, one less wrap on the band. So now you're pretty much just holding onto the ends. We'll sit up nice and tall. We'll have a softness in the elbows, but they're pretty much straight. And we're opening that band straight out wide. Squeezing between the shoulder blades. Breathe out as you open, draw the shoulder blades together. Breathe in as you close. Good. Now you've got options here. You could come slightly lower if you feel like this is bothering your shoulders. We're going to mix it up a little bit. We'll do three more of these. Just get that sense of squeezing the shoulder blades without flaring the chest. Two, one more. Good. Now I want you to go up a little bit higher, a bit of a Y shape. Good. And then a little bit lower down towards the floor. Let's go up. Good. And down. Good. Squeezing between the shoulder blades. If you find this is too tight, bend your knees. It'll take some of the tension off the band. And then you've got an option to make it a little bit lighter again by grabbing even further down the straps. Let's go for another five each way. Good. Four. That's it. Three. Really emphasize that squeeze. Two. Last one of each. Down and up and rest. Well done. Roll those shoulders out. Reach forward, grab your toes, give your legs a little shake. That was very good. Well done. All right. Let's just pop our band beside us for a moment. Roll onto your side. Bring your top knee in front of your bottom knee and rest all the way down. You can pop your head onto your bottom arm. And we're going to reach the top arm forward, bring it up towards the ceiling. Fold all the way over back behind you, trying not to let that front knee lift. You're going to end up in quite a rotated position there through the spine. Hold here. I want you to reach that right arm up and over your head. See if you can trace the floor with your index finger. And then roll all the way back over. Face the front. And again, reach up overhead. Rotate through the spine. Don't let your top knee lift. As far as you can, you'll feel that that knee wants to lift and you resist that. And then we go overhead, trace the floor, draw a big arc through your arm, and then come all the way back to the front. Let's do this three more times. We'll open the chest, rotate. Good. Reach overhead, long through the fingers. Over we go. And come to rest. And I think this might be the last one. Overhead. That's it. Keep that knee on the ground. Reach all the way up and over. All the way. And then come to rest there. Beautiful. Come onto your hands and knees. And then we're going to reach the stool on the right arm during the reaching. So keep your left hand on the floor. Just slide your right hand along the ground underneath you. Let your chest twist to the left this time. Good. And then slide it back along the ground and reach up to the ceiling and rotate your body that way. Good. So we rotate towards the left, stretching under. Good. And then we come through and rotate to the right. Do this two more times. Rotate left. That's it. Get that shoulder blade to come towards the ground. And then lift up and rotate right. And last one, we're going to rotate through. Sink down, let that shoulder blade rest towards the ground and hold here. Holding, big breath in and out, feel that opening all through the back of that shoulder area. Two, one, come out of that stretch. We're coming into our pigeon, step your right foot forward towards your left ankle, let your knee rest onto the ground. Stretch your left leg out, feel that stretch through the right hip area and hold here. Again, I like to just rest with my elbows straight to begin with. I'm a bit tighter around the hips. Make sure my pelvis is square and then I'll come down onto my elbows and hold here. If you want to go further, let your head rest down. I'm pretty happy with my elbows. And we're just going to hold here for three really deep breaths. You can close your eyes down if you like and just really relax into this position. You can have a go at rocking your hips a little bit side to side and just feel how that stretch changes, or you can just rest there and be still. Good. Press up through your palms. And then we're going to lie down on our other side. So lay down, rest your head onto your right upper arm. We're just about done. Left knee onto the ground. Left arm reaches forward. Let's open out towards the ceiling. Stretch over. Don't let the left knee lift. Trace the floor with your fingers. Over you go. And again, overhead. Get that rotation. And then overhead. Two more times, we twist across. Good. And then we reach up. And one last time, let's twist overhead. Good. And then stretch up, 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 up. Really reach the arm overhead. Good. Come onto your hands and knees. Reaching the left arm underneath the right, rotate the chest towards the right hand side. And then press up through that right palm. Lift your left hand to the ceiling, open to the left. Let's reach under, stretch, good. And then reach to the ceiling. And we'll go one more time, we'll stretch under, this time letting that left shoulder rest onto the ground, really twisting your chest towards the right-hand side, and we'll hold here for a big breath in and out. Come back onto your hands and knees. Bring your left foot towards your right wrist. Stretch the right leg out. Come into that pigeon pose. Keeping your elbows straight whilst you get your hips square. And then once you're there, you can come down a little further. You can always stay on your arms if you want, up on your straight arms, or you can always rest down onto your forehead if you prefer. Whatever you like, let's breathe in and out. Maybe twisting through the hips a little bit, feeling that stretch change. Or maybe just resting in stillness, whatever feels good to you. I like to move, but I'm restless. And let's hold here for another moment. Good. Press up through your palms. Come on out of that stretch. Take a seat. Sit cross-legged. Just want you to sit here for a moment and just get that helium and balloon head feeling again. Broad collarbones, ribs are sinking. You're sitting upright on your sit bones. And you are all done. Thank you, ladies, for another good class. Hopefully you feel that around the shoulders and definitely in the glutes. That's where I've felt it the most. And enjoy the rest of your day.